Robert Aaron installed 16 solar panels on the roof of his Bayview home last year.
Save some money, do some good, you know, good for society, good for the world, ecology, and all that kind of stuff.
He says he saves about $30 to $40 a month because he generates his own electricity. But that could soon change with a new proposed surcharge.
All we're asking for solar customers to use is just to pay a charge that is based on their generation, $12 to $15 a month.
If the proposal passes, about 700 Wisconsin solar customers would be impacted. Right now, they only pay for the energy they don't create themselves. We Energy's officials claim the surcharge would cover costs to run the power grid and therefore save other customers money.
Some of the costs, actually a high number of our costs for our transmission lines, our poles and our wires, are built into that energy charge. Because you're not paying for as much for your energy, because obviously you have the solar panels, you're not paying your fair share. And what happens is those costs get shifted to all the other customers.
But solar experts argue they shouldn't be charged extra because solar power actually helps We Energies save money.
You're actually producing power that everybody else is using for a cheaper rate than what We Energies would produce. And those benefits are not included and the analysis they've run in this proposal so far.
Well, Caroline, when would this new surcharge go into effect?
Patrick, that decision would have to be made later this year by the Public Service Commission after a number of public hearings. And if they do approve that new proposal, then solar customers wouldn't start paying that new surcharge until 2021.
We'll see what happens. Caroline Reinwald reporting live in Milwaukee.